We continue now at the top of Daf Mem Dalet Amud Aleph Masechta Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 44a. The Gemara here was in the middle of discussing the opinion of Rabbi Yehuda ben Lakish that if you have a fire and there's a mace, you're allowed to, according to Rabbi Yehuda ben Lakish, you're allowed to move this mace because of the fire. And the Gemara now is suggesting the reason is because a person is bohul al meso, because a person is concerned about the mace. If we don't permit him to move the mace, then he's going to come to do something even worse. He's going to come to extinguish the fire on Shabbos. Amar Rav Yehuda ben Shila, Amar Rav Asi, Amar Rav Yochanan. Rav Yehuda ben Shila says, in the name of Rav Asi, in the name of Rav Yochanan, halachic Rav Yehuda ben Lakish b'mace. Halach is like Rav Yehuda ben Lakish when it comes to mace. We are lenient to move the mace, mipnei hadeleka. Gemara continues the two dots. Ein neosin heimenu lefisha eino min amuchan. You're not allowed to get any benefit because this oil that was used for burning the candle is not muchan. Tana Rabbanan, we learned in a brisa, moser hashemen shebener. If you have leftover oil in the candle, visha bekaara, or in the plate, again, that's used to create a fire for a candle, usher, it is usher to use that that shemen, because according to the Tana Kama holds of muksa, so this stuff became muksa, and even if it's extra, it's leftover, it's not burning anymore, it's a problem. Rabbi Shimon matir, Rabbi Shimon says it's mutter. We're going to see, as we've quoted before, and we'll see in the next Mishnah, Rabbi Shimon does not hold of muksa, and therefore it is not a problem. The Mishnah says, "Metaltelin ner chadash avelo yashin." The halacha is a person is allowed to move around a new candle, but he cannot move around an old candle. Rabbi Shimon Omer, Rabbi Shimon says, "Kol haneros metaltelin." All neros can be moved around on Shabbos, chutz min haner hadolek b'Shabbos, with the exception of a candle that is actually in the midst of burning on Shabbos. So Rashi here explains, "Metaltelin ner chadash she'eno maus v'chazi lishtamushe lahedya shelo dolak bo ner me'olam." This is something that's not disgusting, and it can be used outright, and there's no problem, since there's never been a candle there's no problem of muksa at all. Avalo yashin de muksa machmas miyusu. However, the Tana Kama holds the reason why you can't move around an old candle is because an old candle is disgusting, and that falls into the category of muksa machmas miyus. So the Gemara now says, Tana Rabbanan, we learned in a brisa, metaltelin ner chadash avalo yashin divrei Rabbi Yehuda. This is the same as the opening Tana Kama of our Mishnah. It says that you're allowed to move around the new candle and not an old candle, and the brisa tells us that this is the opinion of Rabbi Yehuda, again, who we've quoted before, holds of muksa. Rabbi Meir, Omer Rabbi Meir says, kol haneros metaltelin, you can move around all candles, chutz min haner shehidliku bo b'Shabbos, except for a candle which was lit on Shabbos. It's no longer lit, but it was lit. Rashi explains here, chutz min haner shehidliku, v'af agav shekava aser, even though it's been extinguished, it is aser. The islay the Rabbi Meir muksa machmas iser. Rabbi Meir holds of the concept of muksa machmas iser. Veleslay muksa machmas mius. However, he does not hold of muksa machmas mius. In other words, according to Rabbi Meir, if it was burning on Shabbos, it's a problem because it's muksa machmas iser. But if it's an old candle that was never that never was burning on Shabbos, it was burning a previous time during the week or whatever the case may be, then Rabbi Meir says it's not a problem because he does not hold of muksa machmas mius. He makes this distinction that Rabbi Yehuda doesn't make. And then Rabbi Shimon Omer, Rabbi Shimon says, chutz min haner hadolek b'Shabbos. The only thing that's problematic is if it's actually in the midst of burning on Shabbos. Rashi says, chutz min haner hadolek b'Shabbos, ba'od shu dolek aser shem yich b'haner. While it is burning, it's problematic because then he might come to extinguish the flame on Shabbos, which of course is prohibited. Kavza, but once it's extinguished, mutter l'tatel, it's okay to move it around. Aval kos uka'ara v'ashashas, but if he has a cup or a plate or a lantern that are burning or that were burning, we'll see, lo yezizem imakomam, he should not move them. This line is unclear. Who is the author of this line? Why is it a problem? We just finished saying that Rabbi Shimon doesn't hold of muksa. Now all of a sudden we're saying kos ka'ara and ashashas are a problem. Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shimon over. Now Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shimon says, "Mistabik min haner hakova umin hashemen hametafteif va'afilu b'shash haner dolik." Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shimon seems to be the most lenient. He says a person can use the oil from a candle which was extinguished, or which the oil that's dripping, and even when the candle is lit, if oil dripped out of it, you can make use of that oil. So the Gemara now explains, the first thing the Gemara explains is this last opinion of the Braisa, Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shimon. Amar Abaye, Abaye says, Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shimon, Savar Lakavu Bechadu, Polagale Bechadu. Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Shimon holds like his father, Rabbi Shimon, in one issue, but he argues with him on another issue. Savar Lakavu Bechadu, the Lesley Muksa. He agrees with his father. He agrees with Rabbi Shimon that there is no concept of muksa, so there's no problem. Muksa machmas isser, muksa machmas mias, anything like that. But he argues in one point, the ilu avu asavar kava in lo kava lo, because Rabbi Shimon held that it has to be extinguished in order for it to be okay. The ilu savar afagav de lo kava. He holds even if it was not extinguished, it is not a problem. Rashi says, kava in lo kava lo de lo shamin and leil Rabbi Shimon de shari b'masisin ela moser shemin shabinever shabekara de majmal achar shakava. We only know from Rabbi Shimon after it's been extinguished that there's no problem. Otherwise, Rabbi Shimon seems to hold there is a problem, and Rabbi Lozer Rabbi Shimon says that is not the case. So the Gemara now continues. Aval kos ukaara v'ashashis lo yezizim imakomam. So it says that if you have a cup or a plate or a lantern that had oil in it, those cannot be moved. So the Gemara says, Maishnahani. What's the difference in these cases? Right? Rabbi Shimon seemed to say that everything is okay because he doesn't hold a muks. And then all of a sudden, in these cases, kos karav ashashas, it's a problem. What's going on? Amarula Ula says, Seifa asan Rabbi Yehuda. This line, this Seifa follows the Ashita of Rabbi Yehuda. Essentially, mid-gear, the Braisa is switching authorship, switching Tanoim, and saying, Rabbi Yehuda's opinion is you can't move these items. So the Gemara says, Maskif lo Marzutra. Marzutra asks, Ihachi, if so, my avol, what do you mean, but? It shouldn't be but. This is a new Tana talking. It's not. It sounds, when you say the word avol, it sounds like Rabbi Shimon said, this is mutter, but this is aser. So he doesn't like this answer. Elo Amar Marzutra, rather Marzutra says, Leolam Rabbi Shimon, really the author of this line is Rabbi Shimon. V'chika shari Rabbi Shimon b'ner zuta. Even Rabbi Shimon, he only permits it by a small candle, the daite lovi, because he had an intention originally that this thing was going to go out. It was going to be extinguished, and he would use it afterwards. Avalhani denefishi lo, but when you have these items, a plate or a cup or a lantern, they're a large amount of oil, you don't have any intention, and therefore even Rabbi Shimon would admit that it's a problem. Rashi says, Bezuta de daite ole mibod yom. He had das on this from before Shabbos. Sover shiichla Hashem and maher, he thought that the Shemen would go out quickly. Vishtamish b'ner l'kashiyich ben, he would use this candle when it would be extinguished. So that's how the Gemara makes this distinction. Again, b'ner zuta de daite love avalhani de nefishi lo. But these things which are a lot of oil, we do not say that. But the Gemara now asks on Marzutra from the following Braisa of Tanya, but we learned in a Braisa, Moser Hashemen Shebener Visheb'e Ka'ara Aser V'Rabbi Shimon Matir. In this Braisa, it mentions a Ka'ara, a plate, and it says that the Tanakhama says Aser, but Rabbi Shimon says Mutter. Now, according to Marzutra, by Ka'ara, Rabbi Shimon says it's a problem because it's large. So the Gemara answers, Hasam Ka'ara Dumya Dener, Hacha Ka'ara Dumya Dekos. Over there, we're talking about a plate that's similar to a candle, meaning a small plate. And over here, where we're strict, we're talking about a plate that is similar to a kos, to a cup, meaning a large plate. So by plates, since they come in different sizes, sometimes Rabbi Shimon says it's mutter, sometimes Rabbi Shimon says it's aser. Gemara now continues, Amar Rabbi Zeira says, Pamut Shehidliku Bo B'Shabbos. If you have a pamut, which you light on Shabbos, L'divrei HaMatir Aser, L'divrei HaOser Mutter. According to the one who says Mutter, it's Aser. According to the one who says Aser, it's Mutter. This is questionable among the Rishonim, what exactly this means. We're going to take a look at Rashi over here. So Rashi says, Pamut Menorah Shal Matchis Ve'ena Me'usa. The way Rashi understands it is that this is basically a menorah of metal, essentially a regular menorah that doesn't get Mo'us. So you're not going to have the issue of Muksa Machmas Mius. That's how Rashi understands this Gemara. And he explains, L'divrei HaMatir, who's the Matir? And again, this also is a subject of Machlokas Rishonim, but Rashi says, Rabbi Meir HaMatir B'ner Yashin. We're talking about Rabbi Meir, who normally matirs when you have an old candle, because he doesn't hold a Muksa Machmas Mius. Oser Bahai. But he is going to say that this is a problem. De Muksa Machmas Isser, because it's Muksa Machmas Isser. K'nektani la'el chutz min haner shedliku bo b'Shabbos. Because even Rabbi Meir agreed, if you have a candle which was lit on Shabbos itself, it's a problem. So the first statement makes perfect sense with what Rabbi Meir said before. Rabbi Meir says there's no problem of Muksa Machmas Mius, and there is a problem of Muksa Machmas Isser. Now the Gemara said, L'divrei ha'oser, according to the one who says Oser, the way Rashi understands, Rabbi Yehuda ha'oser, b'ner yashan shel cheres, Rabbi Yehuda who said that a ner yashan of pottery is a problem, hasam hu demos, that's because it's a muksa machmas mias. Aval hacha shari, v'les le muksa machmas isser. The Gemara is saying Rabbi Yehuda does not hold a muksa machmas isra, which of course is difficult, the opposite of what we said before. But that's how Rashi understands Rabbi Zeira's initial comment. L'divrei hamatir osir, l'divrei ha'osir mutter. So the Gemara asks, L'meimer, do you mean to say that Rabbi Yehuda muksa machmas mius islay muksa machmas isra? Let's say that Rabbi Yehuda holds a muksa machmas mius and he doesn't hold a muksa machmas isra. That's not true. V'atani, we learned in a braisa, Rabbi Yehuda, Omer, Rabbi Yehuda says, Kol ha'neiru shel matchis metaltin chutz min ha'ner shehid liku bo b'shabbos. All metal candles can be moved around except for a candle which was lit on Shabbos, presumably because it's muksa machmas isser. So the Gemara says, Ela yitmar hachi yitmar. So if you're going to say anything, here's how it should be said. Amar b'zer, b'zer says, Pamut sheliko olav b'Shabbos. If you had a pamut which was lit on Shabbos, divrei hakol aser. Everybody agrees it's aser because it's muksa machmas isser. Everybody here, presumably according to Rashi, would mean Rabbi Meir and Rabbi Yehuda. Lo hidliku olav, divrei hakol mutter. But if they didn't light it, everybody would then agree it was mutter because it's not mius. It's not Isser, there's no problem with Muksa at all. Gemara continues at the two dots. Amar Rav Yehuda, Amar Rav. Rav Yehuda says in the name of Rav, Mito sheyichado lemos asr lataltala. If I have a bed which was designated to put money on that bed, it's asr to move it around. Rashi explains, sheyichado lemos mitzara b'hazmana b'alma. The chiddush here of Rav Yehuda in the name of Rav is that it becomes asr just by hazmana, just designation alone. V'ava b'shelo hiniya chalem yol. Even though money wasn't placed there at all at any point in time, just the designation makes it muksa. So the Gemara asks Meisvei, they ask the following question. Meisvei Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak, Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak asks as follows, Metaltlin ner chadash avalo yashan. It says you can move around a new candle and not an old candle. Rashi explains the question. Metaltlin ner chadash v'ha Rabbi Yehuda ka'amar la de islay muksa. This is Rabbi Yehuda who holds of muksa. Alma lo mitzer b'hazmona. And you see that hazmona alone is not enough to make it aser. Midakamar avalo yashan v'lo katani avalo hamiyuchad l'kach. Right? It says you're allowed to move a new candle. You can't move an old candle. The implication of the braisa is that designation alone doesn't make it a problem of muksa. It has to be an old candle. It has to actually have been used at some point in time in order to be muksa. And the Gemara will continue this discussion on Daf Mem Dalet Amud Beis, and we'll see that in the next video.